Well, in the last decade, we've seen so many innovations in medicine, from an HIV prevention pill to 3D printing of human organs.
So what's in store for the 2020s? Dr. Denise Pate, a primary care physician at Medical Offices of Manhattan, joins us now with more. Good morning.
Good morning, ladies. Thanks for having me.
Thank you for being here. So it really is, there is so much innovation these days.
There really, really is. And I think that now the 2020 is upon us, and the next decade, we have so much to look forward to in terms of health and medicine. I think one of the biggest things, though, is that we will be seeing a more personalization of medicine, mm-hmm. something that we do try to adapt in our practice, where we realize that medicine is no longer a one-size-fits-all situation mm-hmm. for all patients and people. And we try to adapt our programs that we are helping to make patients learn about in terms of having them realize that there are different lifestyles that they're coming in with, and us being able to apply what their backgrounds are in those lifestyles.
Yeah. And new technology is really kind of helping this along.
Mm-hmm. Listen,
you know, we were talking about the Apple Watch, mm-hmm. and actually I had my mom get one because it let you know when the person falls.
Yes, exactly. So that's one of the newer innovations in the newer Apple Watch, mm-hmm. is that it is able to detect falls. So for people who are older, that definitely is important. For people who maybe have mobility issues, neurological problems, it's also very important. In addition to the Apple Watch, currently what we do know is that it's able to detect different heart rhythms. Mm. So that's something that's come out recently, and we are only going to be seeing more innovation in terms of that. So we're able to detect things like atrial fibrillation, which is an extremely important and dangerous heart rhythm where someone's heart goes irregular. And if someone has atrial fibrillation already, they're able to detect if they're going in and out of it with techniques like the Apple Watch.
Wow. And you were also talking about at-home fitness, mm-hmm. will be a big trend again over the next decade, like Peloton, for
certainly,
example.
Certainly, yeah. So I think in the 1980s, we saw booms in at-home fitness in terms of things like Jane Fonda workout videos. Mm-hmm. And then in the 90s and the 2000s, we moved more towards large chain gyms. And in the past decade, we've seen small boutique fitness groups mm-hmm. pop up. And now what's happening is those small boutique fitness groups are coming into people's homes. So if people cannot get to the gym or don't have access to a local fitness group, they're able to be using these modalities at home.
Now, also, we hear a lot about plant-based diets. Mm-hmm. Is that where we're going?
Well,
because I don't know.
I don't know either. I don't know if it's for me, but yeah. What I can tell you is that I think one of the misnomers of plant-based diets is that people are thinking that it's plant-only mm-hmm. diets.
Okay.
Very important to realize that it's really just plant-based, meaning that the majority of the foods are going to be based in plants. So fruits, vegetables, nuts, seeds, plant-based oils, but you're going to be gaining your proteins from things like lentils, legumes, chickpeas, tofu. But it's also important to realize that it's not a plant-only diet, so you right. are able to sprinkle in other types of proteins.
Right.
You still can have meat, you still can have chicken. Mm-hmm. And we do see that the fast food industry is really taking a hold of
yes.
this as well by offering things like plant-based burgers.
Mm-hmm. So next time you go to your favorite McDonald's,
I'll get that one of those plant-based burgers.
Well, you may want to try it.
Let's talk about virtual reality in medicine.
Yeah.
What trends are you seeing that'll be coming forward?
So I think one of the things that we're seeing a lot is the boom of telemedicine. Mm-hmm. And so telemedicine essentially is where people can be in their own home or even at their office and have access to providers. So no longer can the excuse of I can't get in to see the person be used. Mm-hmm. So essentially what we're seeing is that visits can take place through telecommunications, through things like Skype or FaceTime or
even when yeah. it comes to urgent care
yes,
as well.
Exactly.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So basically what you're seeing is that people can have visits with doctors at a distance. I do caution this, though, because while for certain things it can be helpful, mm-hmm. I do think it's important in areas like psychology, mental health, where a physical exam is not necessarily important. Mm-hmm. If it's something that you're concerned about, if you're having a cough or a cold or chest pain, you really want to see
a
doctor in person.
Interaction.
Absolutely.
Thank you, doctor.
Yeah.
I appreciate it.
Thank you. Thanks for having me.
And for more information on these health trends, you can head to CBSNewYork.com.
We'll be right back.